This is San Diego News Daily.
Welcome to San Diego News Daily. I'm Jackie Crea. San Diego Mayor Todd Gloria says city crews will be working this weekend to address an issue which has caused downtown to become a whole lot noisier than usual. People who live and work downtown, especially in Little Italy, say they haven't been able to get any peace and quiet recently because of those constant train horns you hear. Typically, downtown neighborhoods are quiet zones for trains, but the Federal Railroad Administration recently lifted these quiet zone designations due to safety concerns. The FRA says some of the rail crossings do not meet federal guidelines for quiet areas and need more safety measures if trains are not going to blow their horns. Now, this has caused several downtowners to get a rude awakening, including Daniel Perry. He is a nurse who works the overnight shift.
It makes it very hard, particularly for me, where I work at nights in the hospital to sleep. I would have thought with the infrastructure they have in place here, they should have had this all figured out.
Now, Mayor Todd Gloria recently addressed the issue, saying he fully recognizes and apologizes for the distress this has caused those who live in downtown. He went on to say city crews are working on replacement signage, pavement markings, and flex posts identified as deficient. We will work through the weekend until all of these tasks are complete. Now, Gloria said all of the work is expected to be done by the end of the month. Then the FRA will have to confirm the guidelines have been met. Longtime San Diego politician Toni Atkins has officially launched her campaign for governor with an event at the Air and Space Museum in Balboa Park.
Announcing my candidacy to serve as governor of California.
Now, the announcement had been expected for months as there has been widespread speculation that she's considering higher office. Atkins had already announced plans to step down as Senate pro tem next month, and last summer Atkins set up a fundraising committee to explore a possible run for governor. California voters have never elected a woman to the governor's office, nor a person who is openly part of the LGBTQ plus community.
It's time for California to finally elect a woman governor. As the most qualified candidate running for governor, who also happens to be a woman, I agree.
Now, Atkins started her political career here in San Diego as the District 3 City Council member in 2000. She went on to become the first lesbian to lead both the state Senate and Assembly. Last year, she also became the first LGBTQ plus member to sign legislation while filling in for the governor. Atkins joins three other Democrats in the race to replace Governor Newsom. Lieutenant Governor Eleni Kounalakis was the first to formally announce her candidacy just a few months into Newsom's second term. State Superintendent of Public Instruction Tony Thurmond is also in the race, along with former Controller Betty Yee. And Attorney General Rob Bonta has also said he is seriously considering a run. And as you're starting to consider candidates in this year's race, keep an eye out for your ballot in the mail. The Registrar's Office says ballots will go out in about 2 weeks. Voters will have the option of placing their ballot in any of the drop boxes across the county starting February 6th, or you can vote in person at the Registrar's Office starting February 5th. Neighborhood vote centers will open February 24th, and again, Election Day is Tuesday, March 5th. This weekend in Carlsbad, you will not be able to take the train. The coaster will be stopped between Oceanside Transit Center and Santa Fe Depot for maintenance. There also won't be a replacement bus connecting the stop, so if you normally take the coaster, plan ahead. Instead, you can take Breeze Bus Route 101 or look into other MTS connections. The coaster will be back on schedule starting Monday. And are you sick of potholes and bumpy roads in your area? Seriously, for the first time in 7 years, the city of San Diego has completed an assessment of every paved street across the city. The report is not so good. In fact, our roads are now rated below industry standard. NBC7's Nicole Gomez was at the press conference where the plan moving forward was laid out.
Well, there's really no hiding from the facts that came out of this survey, and the transportation department says, look, we need funding year after year in order to get our San Diego streets back up to the industry standard within the next decade. And according to this new report, there is a long way to go. It's been 7 years since San Diego analyzed every paved street in the city, a survey which should be done every 4 years. And the data isn't good. The city's new score is a 63, below the industry standard of 70, putting us below other big cities like San Francisco, San Jose, and Phoenix. And in order to get the city back up to industry standard, they're proposing a plan to more than quadruple annual spending on road repairs for the next 8 years. The city would spend $213 million per year compared to its annual average over the last 10 years of $46 million. So if the plan is approved, what would the money go toward? San Diegans often feel like the patchwork fixes after rainy months are just a Band-Aid approach and not long-lasting.
So our team is proud of San Diego. We're proud of the work that we do with the limited resources that we have, and we are San Diego at work. So we're out there every day utilizing what we have in front of us, but ultimately to be able to achieve the road network that we need and what we want is to have a 70. We need those added investments year over year to get there.
Well, according to the report, the district with the worst roads in the city, District 2, which includes neighborhoods like Claremont, Mission Beach, and Point Loma, communities with some of the most traveled roads. Reporting from Choyas Operations Yard, Nicole Gomez, NBC 7.
And meteorologist Brooke Martell will have a look at your weather right after this.
Looking for NBC San Diego on Roku? The easiest way to find us is with Roku Voice Commands. Just press the microphone button on your remote and say Live TV, and then say NBC San Diego. If you don't have voice commands on your remote, just scroll down to Live TV, click the purple icon, go over to the left and navigate to News, then head on down to NBC San Diego News. Once you got us, make sure you add us to your favorites, and we'll always be right there for you. NBC San Diego News on Roku.
Let's take a look at this rainfall potential for your Saturday. Mostly cloudy skies for the morning, but heading into your afternoon, pretty active. So right around lunchtime, that's when we can expect to start to see some of those rain showers, and they could intensify going into the rest of your day. Even as we look ahead to this evening, there could be some periods where they taper off a little bit, but we are expecting this to continue through the overnight hours into Sunday. I want to talk about what's happening at the coast because we do have a high surf advisory in effect, and wave heights could be anywhere from 5 to 8 feet. Tomorrow morning at 2 a.m. we will have a coastal flood advisory also go into effect through 2 p.m. because of these large breaking waves. Definitely could cause some flooding near the coastline. Here's a look at the hourly outlook for the coast. So if you are heading there this morning, again, a little bit of sunshine, but mostly cloudy skies. Right around lunchtime is when we'll expect some of that rain to start moving through and stick around through the rest of the day and tonight. So breaking down the details here, first round will be tonight through tomorrow morning. It could be heavy at times and widespread. And then tomorrow, scattered showers throughout the day. So this is kind of the in-between phase as we get ready for the second round of rain that will be on Monday, the more intense rainfall, I should say. So it could be heavy at times and also bring a chance of thunderstorms. By Tuesday, we'll get the scattered rain in the morning, and that will be followed by mostly cloudy skies. How much rain could this system bring? Well, between the coast and the valleys, anywhere from 1 to 2 inches, maybe even a little bit more than that when this is all said and done. 2 to 4 inches for the mountains. Desert region could get up to an inch of rain. And also, we could get a light dusting of snow in our mountains, but that would be at elevations at 6,500 feet and above. I'll send it back over to you. Okay, thanks, Brooke. So today is Penguin Awareness Day, in case you didn't know. You may remember back in September, a rare emperor penguin chick was born at SeaWorld. Her name was Pearl. Is Pearl. She's the first emperor chick to hatch there in more than a decade. And now you can see her person along with the rest of the colony at the penguin encounter. NBC7's Audra Stafford takes us there.
Well, 4.5 months later, and this right here is what Pearl looks like. She's fluffing her feathers a bit, but you can see she has grown a lot. And this weekend during Inside Look, you can meet Pearl and nearly 2 dozen other penguin chicks recently hatched here at SeaWorld, and get an inside look at all kinds of other things as well.
There's a lot going on at SeaWorld's penguin encounter.
We have just under 300 penguins in this exhibit.
Who do you have with you?
I have right here one of our chin strap chicks. Now this little guy, in comparison to Pearl, is only about a month old, so you can really see the difference.
Pearl just joined the colony a few days ago, and senior aviculturist Savannah Goring says she's already making herself at home.
When she first came out onto the ice and got to interact with all the other penguins, like, that's what we were working for, so we were all so very, very excited.
This weekend, that excitement will be on display along with the penguins. SeaWorld will be celebrating Penguin Awareness Day as well as Inside Look Weekend.
We have a couple different talks that are specifically going to focus on our chicks, so you can learn all about what we do with these guys, how much hard work it takes. We've got two on Saturday, two on Sunday, all included in guest admissions, as well as some penguin meet and greets.
During Inside Look, you'll also get to walk through this area. This is the SeaWorld Rescue Center, and you'll get to hear about all of their efforts to rescue and rehabilitate all kinds of marine animals. And over at Turtle Reef,
we have six loggerheads, six green turtles, as well as a hawksbill.
You can talk to the animal specialists in and out of the water about their favorite part of the job.
Diving with 13 incredible sea turtles.
It's a chance to learn more about all of the incredible animals that call SeaWorld home, whatever their home looks like.
We want to show them how cool they are and how interesting they are and what work goes into taking care of them.
And that's happening all this weekend during SeaWorld's Inside Look. I'll send it back to you. I'm getting nibbled.
Definitely go check that out. There's more coverage you can count on at NBC7.com. You can always find us on your Roku or Samsung Smart TV app. Thank you for watching. I'm Jackie Krea.